vobiscum. Bless your Saint Evangelium, secum don Lucam. At that time, Jesus said to the disciples, there was a rich man who had a steward, and charges were brought to him that this man was wasting his goods. And he called him and said to him, what is this that I hear about you? Turn in the account of your stewardship, for you can no longer be steward. And the steward said to himself, what shall I do? Since my master is taking the stewardship away from me, I'm not strong enough to dig, and I am ashamed to beg. I have decided what to do, so that people may receive me into their houses when I am put out of the stewardship. So, summoning his master's debtors one by one, he said to the first, how much do you owe my master? He said, 100 measures of oil. And he said to him, take your bill and sit down quickly and write 50. Then he said to another, and how much do you owe? He said, 100 measures of wheat. He said to him, take your bill and write 80. The master commended the dishonest steward for his prudence. For the sons of this world are wiser in their own generation than the sons of light. The Gospel of the Lord. May the words of the Holy Ghost wipe away our sins. Just stand on your feet. Stand on your feet in shame. In what? Yes. Just for a word. Stand in shame. Our master, our father, our daddy says something now that touched me, and I'm ashamed. And I want everybody to please take this shame. For the first time, accept shame. And look at the statement of Jesus. That statement touched me. You may not understand unless the Spirit of God helps you. He says, for the sons of this world are wiser in their own generation than the sons of light. Can't you see that the people that don't follow Jesus are wiser than us? Can't you see how they are enjoying this world more than us? Can't you see how they even protect their own, and we expose our own? Can't you see how they don't fight themselves, but we fight ourselves? There is no way you will win a case that you have with an occult man, with the occult judge on the throne. The occult judge, recognizing the occult man that you are challenging, will maneuver his way and make sure that the occult man will win you. But when you have a case with an occult man and a Christian is on the throne, the Christian will frustrate you and he will say, the occult man has won you. Lift up your hands. Say, oh Lord, make me wise. Take away foolishness from me. Oh God, I come before you this night, and I beg you, take away foolishness from my life. Give me wisdom. Open your mouth and make it your prayer quickly. Father, I beg you to make me wise. Do not allow me to live a foolish life. I don't want to be a foolish priest, Father. Help me to be a wise priest, a wise Christian. Don't be angry with me for my foolishness, oh God. I depend solely on you. Come and help me. Help me to grow in wisdom. Take away foolishness from my life, in my actions, in my relationship, in my words, in my possession. Break the yoke of foolishness. Destroy the yoke of foolishness. Tear down the yoke of foolishness. I don't want to be foolish. I don't want to be foolish, oh God, my Father. Help me to be a wise man. Let me live a life of wisdom. Do not allow me to be foolish. Take away foolishness. In the name of Jesus. Hands up, eyes closed. Every seed of foolishness in your life, I cause them to die. Every rope of foolishness that the enemy has used to tie our brain, let that rope catch fire. Whatever that is pushing you and I into foolish actions, today, let that power catch fire. In the mighty name of Jesus, we come against the perfume of foolishness. Let our environment be sanctified. May wisdom take over our life. I pray for anyone here whose children are living in foolish ways. Because you have come here as a father, because you have come to God as a mother, that foolishness in your children stops tonight. Every tree of foolishness bearing fruits in your family, let that fruit catch fire now. Let that tree catch fire now. Let that tree catch fire now. Let it catch fire now. In the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, I worship you. And I know that today you will show us mercy. Forgive us and bless us with wisdom. For wisdom profiteth. Let everyone here experience your mighty hand. And may the spirit of wisdom rest upon everybody. May men and women see our actions and testify that we are wise. Through the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you. The offertory of the mass. We thank you. You are such a wonderful God. The hour has come, O God, for you to cleanse us. We have come to be sanctified. We have come that you, God, will take away the stain that is on us. That stain denying us of enjoying our blessings. I pray for anyone here that this holy water will touch now. May a drop of this holy water that will touch you set you free from bondage. Hands up, eyes closed. Whatever the enemy may have used to tie you, and because you have been bounded, you are not free to enjoy the blessings of God. Now that you have come before God, may a drop of this holy water untie you. And I use you as a point of contact to reach your children and members of your family. As this holy water touches you, whatever they have used to tie them will catch fire. I say that rope will catch fire. That rope will catch fire. In the mighty name of Jesus. I don't know the strange thing that has entered this temple. The temple of the Lord must be the temple of prayer. So whatever that is in you that is fighting your prayer life, whatever that is in you that is stopping you from relating with your God, may a drop of this holy water make them disappear into the lake of fire. Let this holy water cause them to disappear in the name of Jesus. May God disgrace the devil. Any power of darkness that has settled comfortably in your life, in your family, a drop of this holy water will disgrace them out of your life. It will disgrace them out of your family. It will disgrace them out of your business. It will disgrace them out of your marriage. It will disgrace them out of your church. Resist him and he will flee. In the mighty name of Jesus. May this holy water bless you. Beautiful ideas will come upon your life. Favor will rest upon your face. After tonight, people will struggle to favor you. People will be struggling to favor you. They will be competing who will favor you the more. In the mighty name of Jesus. May a drop of this holy water do something special again. And what is that? Anyone here that the enemy has blindfolded and you are not able to see your blessings, let this drop of holy water open your eyes. You will see. I say you will see. Haggai and Ishmael almost died because their eyes were closed from the well. But when God opened the eyes of Haggai, Ishmael did not die. Now that God is opening your eye, your blessings will not die. Is somebody receiving this blessing now? Your blessings will not die. Your blessings will not die. Your blessings will germinate and grow. In the mighty name of Jesus. St. Paul says, I planted and Apollos watered, and God maketh it to grow. All the good things that God has planted in your life, today they shall be watered. I said they shall be watered. I said they shall be watered. And God will make them to grow. Finally, wave your hands to Jesus. I don't know the owner of this blessing now. Celebrate. Appreciate God before you get it. Thank him with faith before you receive it. As soon as a drop of this water touches you tonight, whoever that is in your life that is the cause of your tears shall be separated from you. Whoever that is in your life, whether in your business or in your family or in your ministry or in your academic, and that person is the reason why you are suffering, that is the reason why you are in tears, that person is the reason why things are not working out well for you, as soon as a drop of this holy water touches you from this altar, there will be a divine separation. There shall be a divine separation. There shall be a divine separation. God will separate you from them. In the name of Jesus. 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 I pray for those of you online. As we receive here, you receive wherever you are. As we receive here, you receive wherever you are. Your faith will grant you your miracle. Through the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I don't know if you are aware that the year 2020 is about to end. But I want to speak prophetically upon somebody's life. That whether the devil likes it or not, that you shall end this year well. Lift up your hands. A lot has happened this year. A lot. But whether the devil likes it or not, child of God, hear me. You shall end this world well. You shall end this year happy. You shall end this year richer. You shall end this year victorious. In the name of Jesus. Hear me. No matter what you have been carrying, we, the sons and daughters of light, we shall end you with testimony. Therefore, you spirit of fear, pack your load and... Whether the devil likes it or not, come the last day of this year, somebody hear me, you shall be singing, you shall be dancing, you shall be celebrating. No matter what the enemy may have been doing, no matter the stories, hear me, this year you will end it very well. There shall be new songs in your mouth. There shall be new songs in your mouth. There shall be new songs in your mouth. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lift up your petitions. Lift up your petitions. Heavenly Father, we have come. We have come to you. We have come to you because we know that you will surely answer us. We have come to you because we know that you have the answer. Jesus is the answer. Lift it up, lift it up, lift it up. We lift up our petitions to you tonight. Almighty God, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the great provider, we call on you to please accept these petitions and bless us now. Let these petitions win your favor. Let this year be a happy year for us. We come to you with tears, we shall go with joy. We come to you with fear, we shall go with celebration. May this petition that we lift up today transform our lives. As you drop your petitions on this altar, and I call on all those online to send their requests now, as we drop them before God, the devil will be put to shame. The Bible says, ask and you shall receive. Somebody hear me, you shall receive. That is the word of God. That is the word of God. That anyone who will ask in the name of the Lord, that we shall receive. So whatever you have come here to ask God, receive in the name of Jesus. God will supply our needs according to his riches in glory. He's the miraculous provider. He will miraculously provide for somebody. He brought out water from the rock. So no matter your condition, something good will come out. Because Jesus is the miracle worker. So I pray that today, may these petitions you bring before the altar of God win you happiness. Let these petitions that we shall bring to the altar of God, and as we offer the sacrifice of the mass, if there's anywhere where they have offered any sacrifice that is affecting you negatively, may this sacrifice we offer today swallow that over. Swallow that suffer. Swallow that sacrifice. Swallow that victim. Swallow that altar. Swallow that native doctor. Swallow that preacher. If you believe, shout amen 7 times. Lift up your petitions and lift up your two hands. Hear me. You will never die before your testimony. I repeat. You will never die before your testimony. You will never die before your testimony. You shall receive the fruits of your labor. All of you that traveled from far and near to this place, you have labored. And you shall be alive to testify. If you prayed for God to give you a key, the key will not arrive when they say you have died. You will be alive to receive your key. Therefore, any power that wants to attack your testimony, I destroy that power in the name of Jesus. Any power that wants to destroy you because of your dream, because of your destiny, because of your blessing, they shall labor in vain. The brothers of Joseph did everything they planned. They even went as far as selling him. They almost killed him. They threw him in the pit. All because they were fighting his testimony. But that testimony came true. I pray for anyone hearing my voice. On this first Friday, all night of November 2020. All those who thought it is over with you shall come and celebrate with you. They shall come and celebrate with you. I love Joseph. Joseph did not pray for his brothers to die. They were alive. If they all died, how will that testimony sound? They were alive. They all came and they could not recognize him. They all came and they bowed down to him. They could not recognize him. They thought that somebody else was there, not knowing that it was their brother. I pray for you. You know, hear this. Oh, thank you, Jesus. I don't know what you are passing through now. I don't know what you are passing, but let me tell you. God, in order to protect you, may make people look down on you for some time. Am I talking to somebody? Whatever you may be passing through now that is very negative, shameful, foolish, stupid, may be the plan of God. Because if he exhausts you now, they will quench your fire. But when the appointed time comes, he will pick you from the potopoto and lift you up. And people will say, not be that woman waiting for potopoto. Not be that man waiting for potopoto. How manage? If you can shout amen, you shall testify. You will testify. So I give you good news that this condition you are in is not permanent. It is just for a season. Because when Joseph was in the prison, nobody valued him. Who values a prisoner? Who celebrates a prisoner? Nobody. Nobody, nobody. But God waited for the appointed time. Even when Joseph was in Potiphar's house, it was not yet time. And when God saw that in Potiphar's house, Joseph was becoming famous, he was becoming influential, he said, no, 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 no. It's not time, it's not time. No, 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 no. Oh, no. Sham, prison. Some of you may be in ugly states now. If I were you, I would celebrate it. Because I know that my Redeemer, that this condition I'm in is not my permanent place. Somebody hear me now. Because you have humbled yourself to come and worship God tonight, God will assign 11 angels to package your life for you. Heaven will assign 11 angels to package your life for you. From today, a heavenly committee has been set because of Father Dibier. A heavenly committee has been set because of you. They will plan everything about your going. They will plan everything about your celebration. They will plan everything about your positioning. They will plan everything about your marriage. They will plan your promotion. They will plan your advancement. They will plan your growing. They will plan your spreading. If you believe, turn around and shout amen. So shall it be. Your prayer will never go without being answered. I say God will answer your prayers. The God of Lumen Christian Family will answer your prayers. Because you are here, you shall smile. Lift up your hands. I don't know the demonic powers that are ganging up against you. But I tell you solemnly, God will assign these same angels to fight for you. You will not fight the battle. You will only pray and worship God. And the angels will be fighting for you. And you will surely win the battle. I say you will win the battle. I say you will win the battle. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hear me. Hear me. Hear me. There must be testimony in your life. Believe me. Believe me. There must be testimony in your family. And that testimony will break record. That testimony will break record. That testimony will break record. In the name of Jesus. Lift up your right hand. Onwerombe ike kwenso bakari ike chuku. Onwerombe ike mado bakari ike chuku. Chimo bianuro onye kerowa. O chimo bianuro onye kerowa. Oh, where are you? ke mami water ka kari ke choko chimo bianu ro piko
oye keru wa bianu ro ka
shall it be in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Finally, lift up your petitions with your two hands. Lord, look at them. Look at the tears. Look at the tears of your people. Look at the pains of your people. Look at the sorrows of your people, God. I present our petitions to you, O God. I present our prayers to you, O God, Yahweh Elohim. The Almighty God, hear the prayers of your people. Do not allow the enemy to continue to mock us. Do not allow us to continue to suffer here. Lord, if our prayers have not been done well, help us with your spirit. Rechannel our prayer that we may testify.
Amen.
Do not allow the enemy to snatch us out of the kingdom. Do not allow us to lose focus. Do not allow us to be put to shame. As we all have gathered again tonight, may you revitalize us. May you recharge us. May you empower us. Let our altar of prayer begin to burn again. Lord, look at them. Look at their fears. Look at their worries. Look at their anxieties. Look at their petitions. Father, fight for them. Some trust in chariots. Some have gone to native doctors. Some are fighting us with their vunchu powers. But we come to you. And we know you will not allow us to go back the same. You will not allow us to be put to shame. Father, please hear our prayer. Hear our prayer, Papa. Papa, hear our prayer. Change our story to glory. Let there be joy again. Let there be joy again. All those who are sick, may you heal them. Papa, all those who are dying of one disease or the other, remember your wounds, oh Jesus, and set them free. For by your wounds we are healed. By your wounds we are healed. In Jesus' name I pray. Those who are asking for the fruits of the womb, your word says there shall be no barrenness in the land. There shall be no barrenness among anybody here. There shall be no barrenness in your family. There shall be no barrenness in your house, because the Lord has said so, and the word of God is yes and amen. Father, look at the poor ones. They cannot feed. They cannot pay rent. Daddy, provide for them. You are the miraculous provider. Hear our prayers. Change our story. Take away this garment of shame. May we put on garment of righteousness. May we succeed and excel in our offices. We pray for protection. And we pray for your direction. May tonight be a special night. When we shall worship you and adore you, let there be flow of miracles. Father, I know that even before we leave this church tomorrow morning or this morning, Papa, this morning, I know that the answers have been released. I know that many of us, within the next few minutes, our answers will begin to come down. Your answers will begin to come down. The answers to your prayers will come down. And you shall testify. You shall testify. You shall testify. When God opens the door for you, no one can shut the door. Today, as you drop your petitions on this altar, I see the door open for you. I see the door open for your family. In the name of Jesus. The Lord said I should pray for somebody. Oh, I don't know the owner of this now. But if you feel that you are interested in what God is giving, lift up your hands. Ah, thank you, Holy Spirit. The Lord said, I should pray that all those that have been frightening you, that they shall begin to fear you after tonight. Now lift up your hands. Heavenly Father, There are people that we are so afraid of. We are afraid of them because of the kind of thing they exhibit. Father, there is this fear that we have because they have some powers that they can use to crush us. But you have spoken now, and I accept your word. That all of them that we are afraid of, that you are putting something in us that will make them to be afraid of us. So, child of God, take it now. Many of them will see you and run away. They will see you and run away. They will never be comfortable with you again. They will never be comfortable with you again. When they see you, they will run away. With the Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. They will see you and they begin to panic. In the mighty name of Jesus. The fourth man in the fire will guide you. The fourth man in the fire will follow you. In the mighty name of Jesus. When the king opened his eyes, he started shaking. He said, what am I seeing? I'm seeing something like God. Child of God, you will never go alone again. The remaining days of 2020 shall respect you. The remaining days of this year shall favor you. The remaining days of this year shall respect you. I say shall favor you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So shall it be. Ajadi. Sacrifice and mine be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. May these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, become for you a pure oblation and for us a holy outpouring of your mercy. May our prayers rise like incense through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him through Christ our Lord. Through him, the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with yours in humble praise as we acclaim. Holy. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gates, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like they do for, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke the bread, gave it to the disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when Sabbath was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of our faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together, our Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, you may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, takes away the sins of the world. Behold, the Lamb of God takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to this banquet.
But only say a word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the working of your power, O Lord, increase in us, we pray, so that renewed by this heavenly sacrament, we may be prepared by your gift for receiving what they promise through Christ our Lord. Amen. Immediately after the mass, and may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, this mass is ended. So let's give God 100 thanksgiving with a clap offering. As you are clapping for the Lord, begin to thank him. Say, "Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus." Begin to appreciate God for your life. Begin to thank God for your family. Begin to thank God for your children. Begin to thank God. Open your mouth and thank the Lord. This is a time for special thanksgiving. Let us begin to thank the good Lord for his goodness, for his love, for his blessings in our lives. Begin to appreciate God. Begin to appreciate God. Begin to appreciate God. Begin to thank God. Begin to thank God. Begin to thank God. Are you thanking God? Are you clapping for him? Begin to thank God. Begin to thank God. You wait there. Begin to thank the good Lord. In Jesus' name. Now lift up your hands. Father Lord, it is time for thanksgiving. We appreciate you for all you have been doing for us. We thank you because you are worthy to be praised. For giving us the month of November, we say thank you, Baba. We are thanking you because we know that you are doing more things for us. We thank you for every member of our families, for all the protections, for all the guidance, for all you have done for us. Accept our thanksgiving in Jesus' name. Accept the gift we have for you, God. For the wonderful things you have done for us, we say thank you. May we all come now with thanksgiving, joining those who are coming to the altar. And may God accept our thanksgiving through the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So let's come to the altar. To the King of Kings. Amen and amen. Our Lord is good. Now quickly, let all those with a tithe offering come to the altar now. We are
well. Onyoma, 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 onyoma.
Onyene me machimo, onyoma mo, onyoma. Let us worship the King of Kings.
Onyoma, onyoma.
Isiato namba, lenoya, onyoma mo, gozibe mo. Odo wa kataka lenoya onyoma mo onyoma
onyoma onyoma onyoma onyoma
onyenye nye mwachi mo onyoma mo onyoma
onyoma
Jesus
onyoma onyoma
chine nye mwale noya onyoma mo gozibe mo Waka Lenoya, Onyoma, Onyoma,
Onyoma, Onyoma, Onyoma,
Onyoma, Onyoma,
Onyoma,
Onyoma, Onyoma, Onyoma,
Onyoma, Onyoma, Onyoma,
Onyoma, Onyoma, Onyoma, Onyoma,
Onyoma, Onyoma, Onyoma,
Onyenye nye mwachi mo, Onyoma mo, Onyoma,
Onyoma, Onyoma, Onyoma, Onyoma,
Ebube no we ya chanyi, Onyoma mo, Onyoma,
Onyoma, Onyoma, Onyoma, Onyoma,
Onyenye Behold the King of Kings, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, Jesus, Igwe. Odogumo, Ikai Jeje. Come, let us adore him.
Omu jupu tara mo bimo.
Let us worship the King of Kings. Everybody worship the King of Kings. The power of God will bless you and your family. People of God, the power of God is here. The Lord is blessing you. The Lord is healing you. Oh,
hallelujah. Just on one
receive power, receive power. There is nothing God cannot do. Child of God, begin to receive your healing in Jesus' name. Receive power in Jesus' name. Receive your deliverance in Jesus' name. Oh, Chairman, Amen, Mana, Gosiani. The Lord is blessing you. He's blessing your family. Your life can never be the same again. Yere mabora magosha ndari makonda se ndari makoma. If Abunajiga happened, I had Jesus. Oh, Achichanya Yendo, now we can. Oh, we worship you, we thank you. Jesus. Ike. Open doors. Upon your children. witness the blood of Jesus. Let the blood of Jesus Christ begin to fight for you. Let the blood of Jesus Christ heal you. Let the blood of Jesus Christ empower you. Obara Jesus be kanyi. Obara Jesus. Omara Jesus barane no be. Awawara no be. Obara Jesus wapor makamona giye. Awawara no be. Obara Jesus metoro na la ewo. Lord of Jesus, 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 we need you. Lord of Jesus, Lord of Jesus, Lord of Jesus, Abarana chwa jomo, Abarana kwoni shafuzo. Stretch your hand of Jesus. Whatever you ask, stretch your hand of Jesus. Lord of Jesus. Lord of Jesus. Lord of Jesus. Begin to work in our family. Begin to work in our destiny. Begin to heal the sick. Obara Jesus. Open door, open door, open door. Yeria basondori amakema. Yegederi kabobobobobo sherema. Obara na tuabo. Oh Jesus. Abambochi wedi kekewa. Ochi wedi e.
Okei e nabo. Ebu iwa bawa. Alamadi jineme. Nda wedi e. Wedi akanobi o.
Oyole bube.
Ewo. Oyabu kwa wanke chuku o.
Look at Jesus. Look at him. To where Jesus I had him. To where Jesus I had him. Ahebube. It's okay. Aha ne bunyo benyenu. Tuoyaha. Mighty God, we worship you. Ike ki ike, obato biye. Oyonlu ebube. Neferayaka, nebunye, neferayaka. That is why you are here. That is why you are here. Begin to worship him the way you have not worshipped him before. Don't be tired. Don't be tired of worshipping the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, and the Alpha and the Omega. Father, we worship you. We say you are holy. You are the man who maketh all things possible. Worship him. Wave your hands to him. Wave your hands to him. Bunye Jesus enu, bunye gege enu. Glorious God. Holy, 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 holy.
Oh,
Yahweh. Bunye Jesus enu ni mkpuru obi gi.
Ndi mozi kiwe na danu kuya. Hanasi so kachine kendi. Uzana diri. Uzana.
Worship him. Worship your God. Worship your God. Lift up your hands for your healing.
You are.
Lift up your hands for your breakthrough, for your breakthrough.
You are Yahweh.
Worship the King of Kings.
You are Yahweh.
Mighty Redeemer.
You are Yahweh. Alpha and Omega.
Let me hear your voice.
You are Yahweh.
Open your mouth.
You are Yahweh.
Open your mouth and sing to the King of Kings. Take it there. Worship him. Worship him.
You are Yahweh. Alpha and Omega.
Just look at him. Wave your hands. Bara baba baba ka shere ma soro ma. Yere ba kusandare ma koma shere ma. Lekenderi kabasundo lekabrakandai kandusi. Yakundo sikari kababakashunde leba sundo leba kandi leba kande leba kore leba kabashundo lebra kandasila. Let God begin to walk in our spirit. Let God begin to walk in your spirit. Let God begin to walk in your spirit. Let the spirit of Jesus begin to locate your spirit and let something begin to happen there. Let there be recharging. Let there be transformation. Let there be empowerment. Let the anointing of God begin to locate your spirit. Let the power of God begin to locate your spirit. Let there be healing. Let there be deliverance. Let there be empowerment now. In the name of Jesus. Listen to me. In 2 Kings chapter 6, from verse 24 to 33, the situation of things in a particular city was bad. The city was experiencing debt and unproductivity. The city, they were in tears. Men were working without receiving the fruit of their labor. Young ones were dying. There was commotion everywhere in that city. The Bible says in Genesis chapter 1, from verse 1 to 3, the world was formless. And then the Spirit of God came. I pray for anyone here whose situation is very ugly. May the Spirit of the Most High God locate you. Lift up your hands upon your family. I don't know the situation of your family. I don't know how formless your family may be. I don't know how formless things are in your business. But let the Spirit of Jesus move from this altar and settle there now. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. I don't know how formless your business is, but there is a way. Name of Jesus. There is a way in Jesus. The world was formless. But when the Spirit of God came, every spoken word came to reality. And as the Spirit of God is hovering around your family, let there be light in your family. As the Spirit of God is hovering around your life, let there be deliverance in your body. Let there be fruitfulness in your family. Let there be transformation in your family. In the name of Jesus. 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 I don't care how formless it may be. When the Spirit of God is there, every spoken word bringeth about testimony. As you lift up your hands, I pray that jobless brother of yours, a door for a job opportunity is open for him. That your sister that is not married, if you're a man, can shake the heaven. There is a marriage taking place in your family next year. Everything heard the voice of God and came into existence. I speak change in your family. That is why I have declared upon everybody in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ that come 2020, it is your year of greater achievements. The devil cannot stop your family. That thing that God said you will do, you will surely do. Your business will grow. Your marriage will grow. Your children will grow. In the name of Jesus. Greater achievement. Let me tell you, whether the devil likes it or not, your sacrifices will be accepted by God. The Bible says in Genesis chapter 4, verse 4, the Lord was pleased with Abel. I claim it for myself. I love that statement. Or see, the Lord was pleased with Abel. May the Lord be pleased with you. In your sorrow, name, Jesus, boon came. In your sorrow, quench your name. Oh, I know ni me ya, agamara puya, agamara pu Jesus.
bouquet, il y a son roi aimé. Clémy, take it, il y a son réponse aimé. Akana,
oh, why not?
Restoration, great provider. In your sorry queen, so name me more. In your sorrow, one name. Oh, I know ni me ya. I got my rapo ya. I got my rapo, Jesus.
Hear what the Bible says. In Genesis chapter 4, verse 25, he said, Adam and his wife had another son. She said, God has given me a son to replace Abel. Lift up your hands. Anointing for replacement. Miraculous provider. The devil went after the son of Adam and Eve and killed Abel. And God gave them another son. And Eve said, hey, the Lord has given me another son to replace. To replace, underline. To replace. To replace. Let me tell you, anybody here that the devil stole your sandal, God is giving you another sandal. Anybody here that the devil succeeded in stealing your happiness, God will replace the happiness. If the devil took anything from you now, whatever the devil took from you, because you are here tonight, there must be a replacement. There must be a replacement. For your brother, your sister, you know, I don't like praying for myself. Because God can do so much. If there's anyone here, you saw your sister losing something, stretch your hand to Jesus. You saw your brother losing anything, Pastor Akai. You saw your friend losing anything. Oh, Pastor Akai. By the power in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, if you can say amen from the bottom of your heart, there must be a replacement. Somebody say, oh Lord, I need a replacement. Jesus. For what the devil has killed. For what the devil has destroyed. In my life. Just as you replaced Abel. Replace what the devil has destroyed in my life. Replace what the devil has destroyed in my family. Replace what the devil has destroyed in my body. Amen. As you lift up your hands now, under the atmosphere of the Holy Ghost, let whatever the enemy destroyed in you be replaced now. Even if the devil took your motor car, that car will be replaced. If the devil took your children will be replaced. Hey, child of God, tell your neighbor, God replaced Abel. God replaced Abel. God will replace what you lost. God will replace what the devil destroyed. Amen. Whatever. Never you joke with the word of God. Oya kaiji webi.
the word. Never. If God replaced Abel, that my television that they stole, God will replace it for me. That my son that died, heaven will replace that son again. That my daughter that died shall be replaced. God gave them another son. And Eve opened her mouth and said, she said, the Lord has given us a son to replace Abel, whom Cain killed. So she called him Seth. S-E-T. Seth. Fagabo Seth. Afagabo Seth. She could give him to replace Abel. Let me tell you, Abel was already an adult. But he was replaced. I don't know what the enemy took from you when you were a nobody. When you were small in KG1. If you were nke di me, makanage, I am all. I kneel before Jesus. Whatever, when I was in my mother's womb, whatever, when I was in primary school, when I was in secondary school, when I was a nobody, when I was a small boy, when I don't know how to speak, I don't know anything, and the devil was walking, devil was wiser than I was. Whatever the enemy took, whatever the enemy stole, whatever the enemy collected from my body, from my spirit, from my destiny, with this knowledge, with this revelation, I need that now for divine replacement, for divine replacement, for divine replacement, divine replacement, in the name of Jesus. They shall be replaced in Jesus' name. 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 Merembia, merembia, onyobona o. Merembia, merembia o. Everybody, everybody. Merembia, merembia. Imani yawi merenjin so. Merembia, oga somo e. Yeri amasuri ama. Worship him. Merembia chine mema. Merembia, merembia, o papa. Merembia chine mema. Imani awi merendioso. Merembia o aga somo e. Heavenly Father, arise. I know you can do it. Oh God, somebody. Oh, your name is Mao. She the Mago. Does he be Jesus? Does he be? Bigona, bigona, bigona. For me, my God. Oh God. Bless me, Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Stretch your hand to Jesus. Miraculous provision. In Genesis chapter 7, verse 23, something happened there. Basaka. Magano kuchuku kaiji wena aganjem tata. I'm seeking the face of God for insight in some passages I am bringing. The word of God says in that Genesis chapter 7, verse 23, that the Lord destroyed all living beings on the earth. The only ones left were Noah and those with him. That no matter how destruction will come on earth, may you be among those that will survive. Because the way things they happen now, they fear me. Says coronavirus just come. For Europe, people don't die. Some of them never believe that they will die this year. Look at the one happening in our own little village called Utokmo. Where young boys and girls are dying with what we don't know. I say, even when destruction comes, Noah and those who are there around them, nothing happened to them. Yeah. Lift up your hands. Let us tap to that. Heavenly Father, I pray that no matter the destruction in the world, mark everybody here with the mark of survivor. Receive the mark of survivor. Child of God, don't look down on what is happening today. Believe me. Because we don't even know that will happen in December. Nobody know. All these bad, perilous time stories. If Noah survived. If Noah and his family survived. Somebody here, hear me. You will survive. Abu Mojo Wemo Amaraya. Abu Mojo Wemo
Amaraya Ji.
Abu Mojo Wemo
Amaraya Ji Maka Kamgarida.
If Noah survived, the anointing for survival, the anointing to pass through 2020 will rest upon you. Because the too much. Just look at what happened during this youth protest. Many died. Go to Aba, people died. Lagos, Pakistan. Nobody believed. Lift up your hands. Genesis 21:1. God blessed Sarah as he promised Abraham. And Abraham was blessed. I pray for someone here. Listen to me as your hand is lifted up. Because I am picking out some messages, powerful revelation. All the promises that God made to you. All the promises that are for you. Just as God fulfilled the promise of Abraham, God will fulfill your promise for you. All the promises that God made for you shall be fulfilled. You know what? Sometimes you don't even know. But if I read the Bible, I will see my promises there. He said, I will be the head and not the tail. He said, no weapon fashioned against me
He said, whatever I lay my hands upon. These are promises. All the promises, that, whether today you are begging for food, if God promised that you will be a millionaire, let me tell you, from begging for food to becoming a millionaire is like this before God. And you will be that. The God that fulfilled the promises in the life of Sarah and Abraham, that God is visiting you this year. Eve said, God has replaced Abel. When there's anointing of replacement. Let me tell you, if you understand this message, you come and say, devil, steal your thing on spoil. You'll laugh. Because when I read the Bible, I saw the miracle of God in the life of Job. That even the blessings that came in the life of Job, the Bible recorded they are better than the former. So all of you that the enemy took or stole or destroyed what belongs to you, God will replace them with better ones. God will replace your children with better ones. He will replace your business with a better business. He will replace them with better business. In Jesus' name I pray. In Genesis chapter 28, verse 10 to 22, Jacob had a dream at Bethel that changed his life. Jacob had a dream that changed his life. And in Joel chapter 2, Bible says, young men shall dream dreams. Child of God, today, as you stretch your hand to this altar, because some of us want to dream again. We know they think again. We know they sit down, change trauma. If you can say amen to this prayer, listen to me. Your life will change. Because God is giving you now, today. He is marking good. He is giving everybody here the vision, the dream, the ideas that will change your life. Your life can never be the same again. Your life can never be the same again. Take it in the name of Jesus. Receive in the name of Jesus. The dream that will change your life. It comes from God. Comes from God to change your life. The idea, vision that will change your life. In Genesis chapter 41, 37 to 57, Joseph was made a governor in a foreign land. I'm picking out the word of God, though. I will soon move from Genesis and enter Revelation, Exodus. From Exodus, I go enter. We don't pick small moment that they hear. For those when God won't bless today. Somebody became a leader in a foreign land. Miraculous provision. How did God do that? Think of it. I don't know where you are today. I don't know where they have taken you to. But let me tell you, because you are a child of God, you shall be a king in that place. You shall be a king there. Anywhere you settle, anywhere you settle, people of that town will respect you. Anywhere you settle, even the king of that town will respect you. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Exodus chapter 1, verse 19, there is a mystery there I want us to enjoy. God blessed the two midwives. He was good to them. Two midwives. Why? because they were doing good. Open your hand like this. There is, let me tell you, hear me, eh? I get one belief, say, no matter how person bad, he don't do good. No matter how person bad, he don't do small good. Are you hearing me? I believe that. Person not a bad finish. Person not a bad finish. Even thief, fist it that somebody water. Open your hand. My prayer for you is this. The God that blessed those two midwives for protecting the lives of the Jews, may that God look at you and all the good things you have done, that no one has rewarded you for it. As you have opened your hand now before your master, may God reward you. May God reward you. In the name of Jesus. In Exodus chapter 2, verse 5 to 6, the princess saw Moses in a basket and connected him to the palace. Saw Moses in a basket. I don't know the basket life where you live, but you are going to the throne. Everybody run to your seat and bring out your sword. The Lord who answered when I call, you are my miracle worker. Amen.
My Lord and my God, you are a miracle worker. The Lord who answered when I call, you are a miracle worker.
My Lord and my God, you are a miracle worker. The Lord who answered when I call, you are the miracle worker. Amen.
My Lord and my God, you are the miracle worker. The Lord who answered when I call,
bring out your sword.
You are the miracle worker.
Onye nwe mchinaza mekpere, ibugwaro mi yugo. Onye naza mombe mboro ya, ibo mi yugo. Onye nwe
mchineke, ibo mi yugo. Onye naza mombe mboro ya, ibo mi yugo.
Onye nwe mike nonye nwota, ibo gwaro mi yugo. Onye naza mombe mboro ya, ibu gwaro mi yugo.
Onye nwe mchineke, ibu mi yugo. Onye naza mombe mboro ya, ibu mi yugo.
Miracle worker, oh miracle worker. The Lord who answered when I called, you are my miracle worker.
My Lord and my God, you are the miracle worker.
Hey,
the Lord who answered when I called, you are the miracle worker.
Onye nwe mchinaza mekpere, ibu gwaro mi yugo. Onye naza mboro ya, ibu omi yugo. Onye nwe
mchineke, ibu omi yugo. Onye naza mboro ya, ibu omi yugo.
Onye naza mboro ya,
ibu omi yugo.
Ebu be naza mboro ya,
ibo mi yugo.
Choma naza mombe mboro ya,
ibo mi yugo.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Why have I asked you to hold your sword? Make sure you are holding your sword in your hand. Hold it very well and stand up. Almighty God and Father, you are God. you are not man. We have left our home. We have left everything to be here because we believe in you. And we know that you will surely bless us. And somebody will say amen. Ladies and gentlemen, hear me now as you hold that sword. I don't know if you know that God gave you a task here on earth. Please hear me. There is a task given to you by God. You are not here on earth just like that. You are special. You are a chosen person. You have a role to play in the universe. But you can only play this role if you are the salt. When you lose your saltiness, it will be difficult. So whenever we gather here to pray, I take special time to reactivate our saltiness. Whatever the enemy has destroyed, God will repair for us. So stand up in faith. Hold that sword. That is the element God wants to use. You cannot perform your task if you have lost your saltiness. The Bible says men will use you and play football. Your words will not carry power again. When you lose your saltiness, please, we are not just talking about morality. We are talking about your identity. Am I talking to somebody? Not just morality. Not just spirituality, but your identity. Your identity. Who are you? Who are you? No matter the roadblock, when the governor is coming, they must make a way. Are they normal? It is your identity that matters. I am interested in your identity. I'm interested in my identity. Or see, Paul, I know. Who are you? When the devil knows you as a child of God, oh, are they going again, man? So I pray for you now. First of all, let us say, God, have mercy on us. Again. Say it louder. 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 Can you now change it to me? Again. Don't just say it. Be humble in saying it. Look at him here. Say it with humility. Go. Say it again. Now say after me, I am very sorry for living like a rat. I am very sorry for neglecting my identity and live like dog. I am very sorry for neglecting my identity as a human being, filled with the Spirit of God, created in the image and likeness of God, but living like a butterfly. I'm very sorry. When I look at my life, I see Toro spirit. When I look at my life, I see the spirit of parrot. I have lost my saltiness. I am ashamed of myself. Lord, when I look at my life, I am like a pig. Very dirty. Always dirty. That is not my identity. I lost my saltiness. When I look at my life, I am like a tiger. Fighting anywhere I go. I'm ashamed of myself. I have lost my saltiness. Lord, this is my day. I come to you. I come to you with all my heart, that you may remove me. For you are the potter. I am the clay. Mold me. Mend me. Fill me. And use me. I must perform my task here on earth. I must perform my task. And the condition is clear. That I must be the salt of the earth and the light to the world. That is why I'm here. Do something new in my life. Amen. Now lift it up, lift it up. Father, Lord, we are here. Please bless this salt, empower this salt, that as many who will use this salt, may their lives be transformed. Transform our lives. Many of us are deformed. Please transform our lives. Reconstruct our mentality. Reconstruct our life. Reconstruct our body. Reconstruct our behavior. Reconstruct our character. Jesus. 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 Masere makuru mama bashinda rika batunda. Lere makushandere masura bakatula. May the Lord so empower this salt that through the use of this salt you will be blessed. And you'll be totally transformed. Through the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Take little and take. Makushara masendere makuma. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Now stand on your feet with your water. Lift up your water. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We thank God for what He's doing. We thank God for the grace upon our lives. Today, the Blessed Sacrament will be moving around this church for a closer contact. And I pray that you will be blessed. Lift up your water. Are you holding your water? The Lord be with you. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We ask you to bless this water and empower this water. Through this water, let the seed you planted in us germinate. Let the seed you planted in us grow. Let this water heal us, purify us, sanctify us, and empower us. Let this water bring about open heavens for somebody. Amen.